Dear students, namaste. Here today we are discussed new practical oriented topic, that is study the effect of potassium and calcium ions on frog heart. In previous practicals we already discussed what is the effect of adrenaline on frog heart, what is the effect of acetylcholine on frog heart. Here we discussed what is the effect of specific ions like potassium and calcium after administration to the frog heart. What will be the show the responses on heart? Let us check in this experiment. These are the objectives student will be able to understand the environment along with this tissue, to understand the role of this potassium and calcium ions in salt, which is very important to pumping the heart regularly. According to physiological salt solution, potassium and calcium are the responsible ions which moves the contraction and relaxation of the heart. So these are the two important objectives for the today's practical. These are the requirements. We use animal is a frog, then physiological solution is frog ringer solution. What are the drugs used for this experiment? We use the calcium chloride and potassium chloride with respective quantities like 10 mg per ml. These are the specific instruments which is used for the conduction of this or to study the effect of calcium and potassium on frog heart. So what is the use of what is the function of this physiological salt solution? Why we use physiological salt solution? In first two lines we got the answer. What is the use of physiological salt solution? It is used to keep isolated tissue and organ preparations surviving throughout the experiments. Means what? Throughout the experiments, by using this physiological salt solution, we can allow these separated tissues or isolated tissues or organs throughout the experiments. So what is the use of these ions like sodium, potassium, calcium, then chloride ions? So let us see this diagram. Here containing extracellular, then membrane and intracellular. These are the layers of this body, the skin. What happens in extra and intracellular? There is one barrier present between these two, name of this cellular membrane. Extracellular fluid containing sodium, calcium and some of these chloride ions, whereas intracellular ions containing some molecules of protein and potassium ions. So it is very, very essential the movement across the cell membrane of these ions we call the action potential. Likewise, in this experiment in 1883, scientist Ringer found that sodium ions is very essential to maintain the osmotic pressure conditions for the heart muscles, whereas calcium used for the contraction and potassium used for relaxation. So according to this, let us see what is the effect of these ions on frogs. So at the laboratory levels, whenever we use this potassium and calcium on isolated frog heart, we can use in chloride ions using the stock solution like potassium and chlorides, calcium and chlorides. So in these two lines we got the answer, what is the effect of potassium and calcium on frog. Let's see if we increase the dose or if increase the quantity of calcium in heart, it leads to heart stop completely at diastolic mode rather than the systolic. But in after administration of this calcium, heart stop at systole, means the contraction. Whereas after administration of potassium, if the quantity of potassium ion is increased, at that time heart stops during diastole. So we got the answer. What is the effect of potassium and calcium? Potassium shows the relaxation and calcium shows the contraction. Now see what exactly after administration of these two drugs on heart. This is the isolation techniques after isolation of this heart. Let us see what happened. We take first the normal contraction. So this is the normal rhythm of the heart. Let us we administer the dose. Here we administered potassium chloride. If you see the graph shows the decrease in the activities. Means what? After administration of this potassium chloride, it decreases. After administration of potassium chloride, shows the decreasing response. So if we see the observation table, at 0.1 ml dose of potassium chloride, all the responses which is taken by heart is decreases. Whereas we increase the dose 0.1 ml up to 0.2 ml, heart blocks in diastole. So after administration of potassium chloride stop solution, heart shows decreases responses, means negative inotropic, negative chronotropics, means heart stop at diastole. So this is the effect of potassium chloride. Now we check the effect of calcium. Before we are going to the calcium, let's see if the dose of calcium chloride, not calcium, potassium chloride increases, heart stops at diastole. Then we inject the dose of second drug, that is the calcium chloride. Then after we record the responses, if we see the responses, heart shows the increases response. Means what? After administration of calcium chloride, heart shows increases the heart rate or force of contraction. So here we discuss the absorption table. If we take the dose of 0.1 ml of calcium chloride, heart shows the increases responses. Means positive inotropic and positive chronotropic effects, or heart showing systolic action, means contraction. But we increase the dose of calcium chloride, heart stops or blocks in systolic mode. So here, after administration of higher dose of calcium chloride, we see heart stop at systolic mode, means heart stop in the contraction mode. Now what is the observation table of these two? So here, in presence of potassium chloride, heart fails to contract and stop during diastole. Means what? After administration of potassium chloride to the isolated frog heart, it shows the diastole or it shows the relaxation. Whereas Whereas where we use calcium chloride are stop at systole means contraction shows the positive inotropic and positive prodotropic effects. But at the higher dose, it increase the dose of calcium chloride, not stop at diastole, not diastole, systole. So if we see the graphical record of this potassium and calcium, if you see, this is the normal response, and here the pink color decreases means the decreases response. Okay, then 0.2 ml. If we see the dose increases of the potassium chloride, heart blocks in diastole means if we increase the dose of potassium chloride, heart showing the straight line that indicates the heart blocks in diastole. What happen in potassium chloride? What happen in calcium chloride? So in calcium chloride, if you give the dose of 0.1 ml, this is the normal activity, this is the normal response, and this is the abnormal, or this is the increases response. Means what? Heart rate, force of contraction, and muscle tone is increased. But whenever we inject the dose of 0.2 ml, heart showing the straight line graph at contraction mode means what? Heart stop at diastole. So what is the conclusion of the today's experiment? Conclusion is very simple. The effect of potassium and calcium on frog heart. I think you know the answer. Potassium shows the diastole means the relaxation, whereas calcium shows the contraction or systole. So I hope all of you got the answers of the today's experiment. Okay, so thank you so much for patience listening. Thank you.